Welcome back to the math lab, everyone. I'm glad you're here. Mia needs our help. Mia's mom left her this note. Your friend is coming over to play at 2:30. Keep an eye on the clock and make sure your room is clean before they get here. That sounds like fun, Mia. What's the problem? Well, I don't know what 2:30 means either, but I'm sure we can use something we already know to figure it out. Mia's note mentioned watching the clock, so the words 2:30 must have something to do with time. Last time, we learned how to tell time to the nearest hour, so we need to figure out what 2:30 means. But what do halves have to do with telling time? Let's start by thinking about what we learned last time. Here's an analog clock like the one we fixed in the math lab. We told time to the nearest hour by looking at the hands on the clock. When the minute hand is pointing at 12, the hour hand points to the new hour. What time does this clock show? It shows 10 o'clock. But our challenge today is a little different. We need to figure out what 2:30 means. Let's think back to what we know about halves. Do you remember what it means when something is split in half? It's when something is split into two equal parts. Let's imagine the clock being split into halves. The minute hand starts at the 12 and takes 1 hour to go all the way around the clock, always moving in this direction. Now imagine there is a line dividing the clock in half from top to bottom. Mia is going to move the minute hand halfway around the clock. But before she does that, think. Which number do you think is halfway around the clock? Let's see if your guess was right. Mia moved it to the 6. When the minute hand is at the 6, half of the hour has passed. That's why we call it 2:30. Mia noticed something about the hour hand. Did you notice it too? While the minute hand was moving, the hour hand was moving too. It started at the 10, and now it's halfway between the 10 and the 11. So how do we know which hour to say? When the minute hand is on the 6, or halfway around the clock, the hour hand will be halfway to the next hour. If the time is 10:30, the hour hand will be halfway between the 10 and the 11, or halfway past the 10. It can't possibly be 11 yet, because the hour hand hasn't even reached the 11 yet. The hour is still 10, so it's 10:30. Look at this clock. The minute hand is on the 6, so we know it's 2:30 the hour, but which hour is it? Let's check the hour hand. It's between the 4 and the 5, but it hasn't reached 5 o'clock yet. So the hour is still 4. That means the time must be 4:30. Now, it's your turn. Here's a new clock. Look closely at the minute hand and the hour hand. What do you notice? The minute hand is on the 6, which means it's 2:30 the hour. The hour hand is between the 7 and the 8, so it hasn't reached the 8 yet. What time is it? It's 7:30. This is kind of tricky, Mia. And it's okay that you didn't get that one right. Telling time is a new skill, and it's going to take practice. Let's look at the clock in the math lab and figure out what time it is. Take a look at the clock and pause here while you figure out what time it is. Did you figure it out? The minute hand is halfway around the clock, pointing to the 6, and the hour hand is 1:30, but not quite to the 2 yet. What time do you think it is? It's 1:30. Mia, your friend is coming at 2:30, so you still have an hour to clean up before they get here. Oh boy, since there's no analog clock in your room, what should we do? Oh yeah, we can use your digital clock. Let's take a look. A digital clock shows us the hour and the minutes with numbers. First, we look at the hour and then the minutes. Can you guess what time it is? It's 1:30. There are 30 minutes in 1/2 hour. So 1:30 is the same as 1:30. Whenever we read a 1/2 time, we can also say the hour followed by 30, like 10:30 or 2:30. See? You can read 1/2 times on digital clocks too. Now that we can read the time to the 1/2 on an analog clock and a digital clock, Mia can keep track of the time until her friend gets here. I'm glad you were here to help us. Remember, we have all the tools we need to solve any problem. See you next time. Hey.